Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, today the 27th of December, Holy Mother the Church calls us to the memory of Saint John the Apostle and Evangelist. Saint John was the younger brother of James, James and John, the sons of Zebedee, the sons of Salome. They were fishing when Jesus Christ came and called them. John was one of the youngest, that's why Jesus had a special love for him. John and James were known as the sons of thunder. John was one of the three apostles who were privileged with witnessing the raising of daughter of Jairus and the transfiguration. John and Peter were the ones dispatched into the city to prepare the young for the Last Supper. John, probably the youngest among the apostles, was permitted to recline on the breast of the Lord. The disciple whom Jesus loved, the most beloved, are the words used for him. He was permitted into the palace of Caiaphas on the night of the Lord's betrayal, being known to the high priest. He was the only one of the 12 to remain at the foot of the cross. This is the greatest thing John is ever known for, to be standing at the cross with Mother Mary. Because all the other rest, they left. But he was one standing at the cross, and it was to his loving care that the dying Savior entrusts his mother. On the first Easter morning, it was John and Peter who ran to see the empty tomb. Even though it was John who ran before Peter, he waited for Peter to enter in. Post-resurrection, we see John spend his life bearing witness to Jesus, whose incarnation he sees as the living proof of God's closeness to his people. The first to recognize Jesus in his appearance to apostles on the shores of Galilee, he is again with Peter at the first miracle after the resurrection, the healing of the lame in the temple at the beautiful gates. Until the persecution of King Herod Agrippa I, some 12 years after the ascension, the apostles seem to have remained in Palestine. When they all dispersed, John went to Ephesus, Asia Minor. Here among the pagans who had kept up the Roman and Greek traditions and philosophies, the logos, the word philosophy, was very huge. And that's how John uses the same logos philosophy to teach them about the word of the Lord, that is Jesus Christ. That's why he wrote his gospel very late, when he was sent to the Patmos Island, when he was very old, 95 around the age time that he wrote the gospel. He wrote a spiritual gospel. He did not want to recount the same things that were written in Matthew, Mark and Luke, because by that time it was in circulation. That's why he wrote not like the synoptic gospel, but his gospel is like the eagle that goes high, which goes high, higher up. And it is he who wrote even the book of Revelation. John's zeal and tender solicitude for his flock was beautifully expressed in his frequent admonitions. Children, love one another. Children, let us love merely. It is said that in the end of his life, John was of his mind. Nothing he would speak. The only thing that he would go on saying to people was, children, love one another. John lived at Ephesus to a very advanced age, having returned from Patmos upon Emperor's death, the last of the apostles to die. John is revered as the patron of Asia Minor and is invoked against rain, hail and lightning. John, the beloved, asks us to be beloved of Christ. Amen.